Do you have an e-commerce store or selling digital products and you instantly want to send e-vouchers to your customers as an appreciation? Then look no further. This video will help you how to achieve that. You will learn how to send personalized vouchers to your customers based on their orders or other conditions that you define. Hey, my name is Manuel. I'm the founder of Techflow.AI and we love automation. In this video, I will show you exactly how you can set up a personalized list of vouchers that you are sending to your customers based on certain conditions. It will make the distribution of coupon codes as easy as possible. So without further ado, let's jump right into it. We have a sample database Google Sheet over here, which basically has some sample orders in here. This can be Shopify, WooCommerce, or wherever you're getting orders from, and we're just storing the date here, an order number, a total, and some sample values, first name, last name, and email address. Of course, in your system, it would be more complex, and you can use any system as the baseline for this. Now, we have a second database, which is our pre-created voucher codes that are personalized, so they are all individual, and we just have a long list here of different voucher codes. Here, we could add additional conditions. For example, we have 10%, 20%, 30% voucher codes, or for different types of vouchers that we want to give out. So you can just expand that sheet and have a different column for a category, for example. Then we have some additional columns for the date given, the recipient that we send it to, and the qualified order number, just for reference for us. After we have sent out the vouchers, we want to know where this voucher code has actually been sent to, and then we can track later on if it has been redeemed, what the conversion rate is with these vouchers, and so on. So this is all the baseline for it, and it's a simplified version, and of course you can expand it to whatever you want. So now, how it works, like, we have set up this automation on Make. If you don't have a Make account yet, check out the description. We have a special link for you, which offers you 10,000 operations for free for the first month in the pro plan, and there you have plenty of time to test out all these kind of different cool automations you can build with make.com. It's our affiliate link. We would appreciate if you create an account with our link, because that also supports our channel and we can create more content for you. Now let's look at this example scenario over here. There are two things that we need to grab first. The first one is we are getting the order. So in that case, we're simply searching rows from our spreadsheet, but this can also be a different source. So it can be a Shopify watch orders module, or WooCommerce, or any other source where you're getting orders from, or simply a webhook that you're sending from any other system, or another scenario here that you want to send out, like a voucher to a specific person. Now, we are just having a simple condition here equal to the order number 10,001, because that is just like the sample data of the first record over here. We just want to try it with this one. And then the second condition is if the tag does not exist, because we want to make sure that we are only giving out a voucher once per order and not multiple times. So in this example, we are setting the conditions like this. And then we have the maximum number of returned rows, just one in that case. For demonstration purposes, we just want to send one voucher at a time, but of course you can send it higher. Now the second thing is we want to get the next voucher that hasn't been sent out yet. So we are checking the voucher sheet, which is the second one over here, and we're checking if there's no date given yet, recipient yet, and that to make sure that it hasn't been sent out before. So we're checking if the voucher actually exists and if the date given does not exist yet, because that's what we're going to update at the end. And the maximum number of returned rows is one, because we just want to get out one voucher to send to the customer. Now, once we have these two values, we're sending the actual email to the client who created that order, or the source that we, whatever source we got them from. So sending an email with the email address from our e-store input in that example, then whatever subject line you want to have and whatever email configuration you want to have here, make sure to use the HTML structure in the body of the Gmail module, because otherwise it will not be formatted nicely. So it requires the HTML tags, and then you can send the voucher code. You can have a direct link, or you can also send that via another source. You can send it via Slack or Messenger or whatever source you use to connect to the customer, and then it will distribute the code. Then next thing we need to do is we need to update our e-commerce store tag, so we make sure that the order is not being, the customer is not receiving the same voucher twice or another voucher. So we're simply updating the order with an tag e-gift sent. So that will sit in the tag column G in that example here, and we have it as a filter at the beginning. So only if the tag does not exist, we would gift or send a gift to that order. And of course, you can make it a lot more complex to say, for example, only if the value is above 200, we want to send that voucher. If it's below, then do nothing, or above another threshold, or only if the order contains certain products, we want to send that voucher. They're like, the conditions are endless, limitless, and you can put whatever you want there. Then lastly, we are updating the actual voucher code. So we have on track who has received it and when that person received the voucher by just simply updating the second Google Sheet as well with the date given, putting the now timestamp here. You can also use format date to format it in a nice format. For example, you can say year, month, and day. And then it will format it nicely for you. And how to use these functions, we have a make function cheat sheet. You can find it in the description below, a link to it. Just download it and work through it. It will explain you how to use all these kind of different functions that are extremely helpful on make and save you a ton of operations, because you can simply use them in any text field. So just going through it here, these are all functions explained in our make functions cheat sheet, and they're extremely helpful. So make sure to download it, it's free and it will help a lot. Next, we put in the recipient, the first name and the last name, and you can also add the recipient's email if you want to, and the qualified order number to make sure the same voucher is not being sent out multiple times. Now let's see how this looks like in action by just running it once. First, we're getting out the next order. As I said before, this can be any source. Next, we're getting the first voucher code that hasn't been sent out yet, which is in row number 2, which is this one over here. And then we are sending out the email with this content here. So here's a gift code, and then the actual code is being inserted. And second last, we are updating our record to contain the tag e-gift sent. So let's check that first. E-gift sent is here, and that will make sure that this is not being sent out again to the same person. And lastly, we are updating our voucher code here with this value of the date, the name of the recipient, and the order. So let's check the voucher. We have the date given, the recipient, and the qualified order number. All right, that's it. I mean, this is the whole concept of automating the distribution of personalized vouchers. Of course, you have to get that list first, but there are also certain platforms that allow you to create vouchers on the fly. And you could also do that in replace this here over here with an API call to create that coupon, that personalized coupon for a specific person on certain conditions, and then send it out and update the order to avoid double sending, or just use a Google Sheet to track the distribution of the coupon codes, and then you can do your own analytics with it afterwards. I hope this video helped you a lot and you are able to create these personalized coupon codes now, which make your marketing a lot easier and your customers more happy. And if you have any questions about that, please put them in the comments below this video, and we're happy to get back to you as soon as possible. Thank you very much for watching, and stay tuned for more.